2020 continues. Once again, John Miller.
One of the most unforgettable moments at this year's Winter Olympics had nothing to do with sports. It had to do with the breathtaking performance of a young singer at the closing ceremonies. Very few people had heard of Josh Groban then, but that is changing now, and in a big way. Bob Brown, with The Boy Next Door, suddenly on the brink of international stardom.
There are smart, experienced people in the music industry who will never forget the first time they heard Josh Groban sing.
I was just thinking, the very first time he sang for me, that was a pretty amazing moment.
This kid was incredible.
You're the guy. I mean, you are the anointed one.
Yeah, you know, I've heard that you have an amazing voice.
And it was on this episode of the television show Ally McBeal that several million viewers also heard Groban for the first time. He played a clumsy, self-conscious kid his own age who sued a girl because she dumped him as a prom date.
I'm not going to the prom alone, Miss McBeal. I'm not that pathetic.
Ally volunteers to go with him to the dance because she feels a little sorry for him.
Thank you.
But she also insists, as part of a lesson in facing the world, that he agree to sing a solo in front of the prom. Awkwardly enough, he begins.
And I can feel your heart in mine.
Because the difference between the character he played and the way he sang was so dramatic, some people thought Groban was an actor whose singing voice was dubbed for this scene.
You're still you.
It was kind of like, well, that was fun. Don't expect to hear anything from that. And then that morning, I got a call from my manager, Brian, and he said, you know, Star Radio in San Diego wants to interview you. I dialed the number. Josh, how you doing? You know, he was the kid on Ally McBeal, and, you know, he sang the song You're Still You. We've been playing it all morning, and I'm thinking, playing it all morning? Oh, my God, what is going on here?
Internet inquiries about Groban happened so fast that he became what one executive called the first internet star. A site for him was assembled hastily, and a CD containing the song he sang on Ally McBeal quickly became one of the top sellers on Billboard's internet charts. Groban has also learned to sing Italian ballads in a collection of songs that was arranged and put together under the guidance of one of the most powerful producers in the music business. He is David Foster, who has won 14 Grammys and has worked with artists such as Natalie Cole, Celine Dion, Whitney Houston, Paul McCartney, Garth Brooks, and Barbara Streisand. Years before that breakthrough episode of Ally McBeal, the seeds of Groban's career were planted in a fairly mundane way. Foster was looking for young talent to perform at political and charity benefits he puts together, and he got a tape from Josh's voice teacher.
I'm always leery when people send me tapes, you know, because 99 times out of 100, there's just nothing there. That's just not really the way that talent is discovered, at least not in my world. But this tape stuck out like a sore thumb.
Groban, who then was only 17, had been told since childhood that he had a voice worth developing.
Someone came up to me and he said, you've got a really beautiful voice. You've got a nice light bulb. You just don't have the power yet.
So when did your voice begin to change?
I was in ninth grade. I was 14, 15. And it was really kind of just waking up one day and realizing I had a different voice. And then you got to take that year to get used to it and say, okay, what do I have now? And start training it.
Please welcome Josh Groban.
Under Foster's direction, Josh performed at the inaugural for California's Governor Gray Davis.
Let me be your freedom. Let daylight dry your tears.
Then he got an even more extraordinary opportunity, an emergency call from David Foster, who needed to rehearse Celine Dion for an appearance at the 1999 Grammys. Dion's singing partner, Andrea Bocelli, couldn't make the rehearsal, and Foster needed a stand-in for Bocelli. Josh, still only 17, was asked to sing Bocelli's part.
I was in a panic. So when I called Josh, and he said, well, I can't sing it in that key.
I thought to myself, maybe one day I'll have a big break, but I don't want it to be like this. I don't want to go in there unprepared.
I really had to do some fast thinking. I said, you know, yeah, you really can, Josh. He said, no, I really can't. I said, Josh, I'm telling you right now, you can sing it in that key. Get down here right now. You cannot let me down on this.
Josh's father recorded the rehearsal on a home video camera. Celine Dion recalled what happened in an interview with Barbara Walters.
And this young man comes on stage, almost going backward. He was so scared. He was going forward, but he was so shoulders like this and scared. So I see this young kid, and I'm like, okay, sure. And do you know the song? He said, yeah, I think I do. He took the microphone, and when he started to sing, he couldn't be any more powerful than that. I looked at this kid, and everybody in the audience that was watching the rehearsal, the orchestra, everybody was, they were looking. This kid was incredible.
Josh has since sung that song many times, here for a Brian Boitano skating spectacular. But what is even more remarkable is that his album, which is now on the verge of going gold with sales of a half million, has gotten play on some radio stations that mainly feature hard rock or hip-hop music.